the story of WoHo Studios is a little bit complicated, so a short presentation is a little hard, but just to wrap it up, we are a small studio from Prague, Czech Republic, and we were founded in 2011, but the real development started of Kingdom Come Deliverance, which is our first game, started in 2014 when we went on Kickstarter. We wanted 300,000 British pounds and got 1.1 million British pounds, so thank you very much for that. And we are right now, as I said, working on Kingdom Come Deliverance, and we are almost finished, so the game is about is almost released.
What can you tell us about the plot of this legal video game?
What
can you tell us about the plot of this video game?
Yeah. Kingdom Come Deliverance is a game that tries to be as realistic and as historically accurate as possible. So what we want to show you is a medieval age, how it really looked like. So we take you back in the year 1403 in the Holy Roman Empire and show you how the medieval life really was. So the plot is that you are playing Henry, the son of a blacksmith. The entire setting of this game, the world, most of the NPCs, all the buildings, and the story is based on a true story. So this is something that really happened. But you, Henry, is fictional, so you can have great impact on the story. And what happens there is that your hometown gets attacked at the beginning of the game. You have to flee to a nearby castle. Unfortunately, your parents die and your hometown gets destroyed and you want to take revenge. But you will learn very quick that you are not strong enough to fight and grab a sword. So you will get in the service of a noble who teaches you how to use the sword. He will give you a horse, and he will give you quests, and he will take you among his people. You will never become a king or a lord or someone, but you will become one important soldier who will have an impact on the history. You will not be able to change history, but you have your impact on that. And you will quickly understand that your personal revenge is not the most important thing that's going to happen, but you will really quickly help to protect your home country, Bohemia, from the invading forces.
What can you tell us about the open world RPG?
Kingdom Come Deliverance is based on a true story, and the setting of Kingdom Come Deliverance is also authentic. What I mean is that WoHo Studios is located in Prague, Czech Republic, and Kingdom Come Deliverance is based round about 60 kilometers south of Prague. So if you buy a ticket to Prague, you can visit all those castles, all those churches, or at least those which are still existing today. So we also took the team, the 3D artists and the concept artists, we went to the castles and churches, we took pictures of the place and we rebuilt all the stuff. So we also hired a full-time historian to the team. So whenever we created the quest of someone, she was coming. Like, for example, we have a big monastery in the game, and our creative owner designers put the quest inside, and she was like, no way a regular guy could ever enter a monastery. So our designers had to think about an idea how we can implement this into the game and maybe change some stuff. So we really put a lot of effort in the game to make it as realistic as possible. And even the features, like the sword fighting, for example, we invited real sword fighters to the studio who showed us how the sword fighting looks like. And we told them why this is not possible for a video game. So we came up with a compromise, and I think this might be the most realistic combat ever displayed in a video game.
Which gameplay can we expect from this video game?
Well, it's an RPG, so of course you have the typical stuff like sword fighting, alchemy system and stuff like this. But Kingdom Come Deliverance, the most important part of Kingdom Come Deliverance is the story. So expect a very, very story-driven RPG. Expect that a game that tries to bring you back in the year 1403, but also expect a game that will not tell you what to do. So we want you to think about this. So if you imagine the old RPGs like pen and paper and the point and click adventures, it required a lot of brain work from you. So Kingdom Come will not drag you through the game and press X and follow this route and there's a GPS system which brings you somewhere. No, you have to, there is a problem and you need to think about the solutions. And when you come to a dead end where someone doesn't want to talk to you, then you have to find another way. So this really requires a lot of brain work from you when you want to play the game.
I am waiting to the development of this game. I have been very long and began in 2009, yes? Can you tell us about this?
Yeah. So the development of Kingdom Come is it's a long story because the studio was created in 2011, but we went on Kickstarter in 2014. So in those 3 years, we were trying to get a publisher, we were trying to get an investor, and we were mainly creating prototypes of the game. So only after Kickstarter in 2014, the real development of Kingdom Come started. So if you consider February 2014, when we kickstarted the game, and February 2018, when we released the game, it's exactly 4 years of development, 3.5. So this is, but well, for those, some people might know that almost all your favorite games, all the GTAs, all the Assassin's Creed, all the Red Dead, they all take so long. But what we did is, because of the Kickstarter, from day one we were telling you, listen, today we work on swords, but we totally messed up the, I don't know, horses because something happened. So every month we were giving you updates and talking to the people, gathering feedback. So eventually it looks like we are developing this game forever, but it's just usual time. We just talk about it a lot and tell you and present you and yeah, try to show you what we are working on.
What
do
you see for you
for a
good RPG game?
Well, a good RPG game for me has the role-playing advantage or the role-playing aspect. What I don't like is RPGs where it takes you and drags you through the game where you just don't have to do just going from A to B to Z to D. And this is what I don't like. I like RPGs. For me, a good RPG is a game where there are several options to do, where you can customize your character, but it's not the visuals. I don't care for the visuals. I care for the character of the game. The way, if he's an aggressive type, if he's a diplomat guy, or if he's like more the sneaky ninja or something. So this is what makes a good RPG for me. When you have several options, where you have several outcomes of quests, where your choices matter, and where you really have to think, what would I do to solve this quest? What was the first one? The music.
Music, yeah.
Yeah, the music in Kingdom Come Deliverance is a production of three guys. One is the composer Jan Walter. The second one is Adam Sporka, our technical musician, let's say. And the third one is Vojta Nedved, and he is the sound engineer. So Vojta is a very crazy guy, so he's recording all the sounds for himself. He's not a fan of sound databases, so he's really going to the forest, taking some metal and some wood, and he's like clapping all the stuff, and he's almost doing all the sounds himself. But he's so crazy that he was recording himself puking. So really, and farting, and really crazy guy. Then we have Jan Walter. So he's a composer, and he's a really genius guy who wrote most of the music, or all of the music he wrote, and some of the music, especially the one for the cutscenes, were recorded in a huge concert hall in Prague with a symphonic orchestra. So we have really a very high quality, high production music in the game. And the third one, also a crazy guy, Adam Sporka. And he implemented something he calls adaptive music system. So the adaptive music is that the game or the music reacts to your gameplay. And it works like this, that you enter different locations or get into different situations like fighting, danger zone or stealing or something. And the music, while you are playing, adapts to your playstyle and shifts to different music styles and music songs. But it sounds like one long song, but in reality it's different songs, but there are transitions in between which are connecting all the different songs to one big one. But for you it sounds like one new song, but in reality it's like different sections. So you see, our musicians, full of crazy people. Paris Games Week. It's of course a very, very one thing is to say hello to you. I mean, when I'm not here with media, I'm standing there at the PCs and trying to talk to the people and try to ask what they like. Sometimes they want to make pictures with me because maybe they know me from some streams or something. But the most important thing is, it sounds a little bit strange, but it's educating. And what I mean is that I try to explain the game and the features to journalists, and they will try to explain it to you. Because I cannot talk to every one of you out there, of course, so the media is the one who will directly talk to you if it's not doing me. So what I'm doing now in the last 4 years is visiting several events in America, Germany, Paris, France, but Poland and so on, and always, and the same we did with after Kickstarter, telling you to the media, listen, we now work on the crime system, now we work on the, I don't know, on the alchemy system, and we explain what we did there, and then they try to teach you or tell you, and this is what I think is cool, that this will give the chance to media, but also a chance for you to actually develop this game with us and understand, ah, now they are working, and you will see that this is, well, when I explain my job to my father, he still does not understand why it does take us 4 years to make Henry jump on the screen. But these, like the way we are approaching media and you, should show you how the video game development looks like.
What would you tell people to do that?
Well, the difficulties in game development is that there's always a bigger difficulty. So whenever you come to a problem, you say, oh damn it, this will be the hardest thing ever to solve. You solve it and then you say, shit, the next thing is even worse. And then all of a sudden, a feature where you thought it would take you 1 month with two people, all of a sudden takes 3 months with six people. So, you know, sometimes it's very hard to estimate how long you take or how long you need for several features. Because maybe you create something which works perfectly, but the moment you implement it into the game, it opens new problems because you need to have interactions and maybe it doesn't work with the quests anymore. So, you know, in the end of game development, you do optimization. And in the end of game development, you put all the stuff inside and put it together. And what you say as a developer is that the last 10% of video game production are the worst and the hardest of all, because, well, you see all the things which are like fighting against each other and you need to work around. But right now I think we are on a very, very good way. We are right now optimizing, we are now bug fixing, and I am very, very, very looking forward to release it in February 2018.
What were the sources of inspiration for this game?
A lot of inspiration for Kingdom Come Deliverance, so of course other games, so of course Skyrims, Oblivions, Witchers, I don't know, Red Dead Redemption, GTAs, so of course you take what you like from those games, but it's story or history itself. So when we created Kingdom Come, it was like, how about we do a game that is historically accurate? Okay, but what story, what history, what part of history? So we thought, you know what, the Holy Roman Empire has so many cool stories to tell and no one ever talked about it before, at least not in an RPG or in a video game. So we thought, this is great, let's do this. And this is how we do it and this is how we work. We had to hire a full-time historian to make it happen, but I think, of course, movies, books, of course even the university and museums and real sword fighters and so on are inspiring us to make this game. Last but not least, of course, you as players, because since we were releasing 5 alphas and a beta, we are asking you for feedback, and we used it when you saw it's too hard, too easy, too much talking, not enough talking. We tried to tweak and change some parts, and I think the result is a joint product.
This game will be released on Microsoft Windows, PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. What is for you the current support to play?
Well, I am a console player, yeah. So I am really looking forward to play this on PlayStation. But, I almost don't care, because from the controls, for example, Kingdom Come Deliverance from day one was simultaneously developed on keyboard and on controller. So the controls are perfect on both. And I would say, well, I don't know. I think Kingdom Come Deliverance has the big advantage that it will be very good, or as good as possible, on all the platforms. And well, of course, the PC is more powerful. So if you are the graphic fans, then you change the choose the PC.
For you, what can explain the success of a video game actually?
Of what?
The success of a video game. What can be the inspiration for success?
What is the inspiration for?
Yeah, for success.
Yeah. For us, as a small studio who is creating the first game, of course, CD Projekt is a big inspiration. So the guys who made The Witcher. And their success story. So in the beginning, they were also pitching Witcher 1, and it had a lot of bugs, and it was not so easy. And the people from America, for example, were thinking, what the hell? Some Polish dudes are creating some video games. So of course, their success story is a big inspiration for us. But we know that we are here, and CD Projekt is there. So we have a long way in front of us, but we are really, really, really nervous and happy and really looking forward to release this game in the near future.
How can Evolve the main character of this game?
What?
Can Evolve the main character
Evolve? In Kingdom Come Deliverance, the RPG system is open, so you're only leveling the stuff you're doing. So in the beginning you are a no one, and in the beginning of the in the end of the game you are still a no one, but better with sword fighting, better in speech, better in whatever you choose. So the customization in the game is very, very open. There's a huge RPG system which allows you to, and that's what I meant, the role-playing part, which gives you the chance to fully customize the character of Henry, of you. So you can solve most of the quests in a peaceful way if you want to spare the people. You can solve most of the quests with fighting, kill everyone if you want. You can solve most of the quests with bribing someone or backstabbing or sneaking. So really there's a lot of options you can do. Then there's a 14 slot armor system where you can put different types of armor over each other, which are good against different types of attacks. So the fighting is a stone, paper, scissor system, where different weapons are good against different types of armor. So there's a really a lot of brain work you have to put in the game, because for example there's a quest and you want to sneak, then you cannot take full plate armor because it's very loud when you sneak, so you need to take some soft clothes. But then when someone spots you and fight with you, soft clothes will not protect you. So really there's a lot of thinking you have to do there.
Kingdom Come Deliverance is one of the most ambitious games coming next year. Are you feeling the pressure to open a new year?
Well, yes, Kingdom Come Deliverance is going to be released in February 2018. It's our first game, and of course, the entire team is extremely nervous. We are right now 110 people, and of those 110 people, maybe 30 people worked on a video game before. So we have a huge studio with a lot of trophies, but like pros in video game development, but also a lot of young guns. So for us, of course, this is a huge thing, and we are very, very nervous. There's no pressure, I think, but it's more nervous and since we are so young, and for me, for example, I've worked on this game now for 4 years. This is almost everyone in the studio thinks that's his baby. So that's a special motivation when you release this game. It's not some kind of product. It's not some crazy publisher came and said, okay, we need horses, we need spaceships, we need something, and now create the game. No, this was a joint idea of our design team and the people in the studio. And we said, how about we do this? How about we do that? And together we come with this idea, and together we identify with this project. And I think that's a special passion, and I hope you can see this in the game.
Can we expect to see some DLC next week?
Yes, after the game, after the release of Kingdom Come Deliverance, we want to work on DLCs, of course. We are going to release a DLC plan soon. But we also want to address modders. We don't know how, we don't know when, but somehow we would like to work with the modding community as well.
Okay, my next question is, which are your current projects?
Warhorse Studios is currently working only on Kingdom Come So the entire team is right now working on